So back to our channel, we are in our CBS Physiology. So today we are going to start the normal ECG, the basics of normal ECG for chapter 33 from our guidance. So first, as usual, first we'll see the keywords, important points, and we'll continue to our chapter. So first we need to check out the Entovens law. So what is this Entovens law? It states that in ECG, for the standard limb blades, the potential of any wave or complex in lead 2 is equal to the sum of potential of lead 1 and lead 3. It is nothing but we can write it just as a formula like lead 2 is equal to lead 1 plus lead 3. That's it. So what are these leads? All this we'll see later. So first we need to understand this law. It states that in ECG, for the standard limb leads, we are using some standard limb leads, the potential of any wave or complex in lead 2, we have potential, we'll also discuss about this. So the potential of lead 2 is always should be equal to the sum of potentials. That is nothing but sum means adding up the potentials of lead 1 and lead 3. So now let us see what is Entovens triangle. So this Entovens only scientist, he also formed a law and also gave a triangle to us. So let us understand what is this triangle. Remember that mainly this Entovens triangle we can see in a bipolar limb blades. We'll also discuss the unipolar limb blades, augmented limb blades and bipolar limb blades. So first let us see this. So it's an imaginary equilateral triangle on the chest. That too it is an inverted triangle, not like normal triangle. It's like this, inverted. Its apex is towards like this and the base is upward. So on the chest, with the points representing the standard bipolar limb blades on the right and left arms and the left leg. So remember that in this bipolar limb blades, mainly we use our right arm, left arm and a left leg. Only left leg. We are not using the right leg because you can imagine our heart is mostly located towards the left side. So the waves, the vector which moves only towards the left side. So we'll not consider the right leg. Only we'll consider the left leg in the case of our leads. So the leads are connected to, remember, in a bipolar limb lead, mainly to the right arm, left arm and to the left leg. We'll also show the diagram so that you can understand clearly at last. So first we'll discuss the points. So next let us see the electrocardiogram. So ECG is nothing but its full form is electrocardiogram. It is, you know, it's a sheet of paper which have many lines. We'll see all those things. So it's a recording of electrical activity of the heart, mainly from electrodes which are placed on the surface of the skin. So just now we are talking about the leads, right? So these leads are nothing but the electrodes which are placed on our either on chest or on limbs. So according to it, it has names like if you place this electrodes on chest area, then it is called as chest leads, and if they are placed on limb, then there are limb leads. So according to the place where they are placed, it has its own name. So electrocardiogram is nothing but recording of the electrical activity of heart from the electrodes which are placed on the surface of the skin. We may get the doubt like the electrical activity of the heart is only within the heart, then how we can measure it by our body surface. We know the fluids all over our body is filled with extracellular, intracellular fluid, right? So in this fluid also the same action potential also travels from the heart, not only in the heart, it also surrounds its surroundings by means of fluid. But of course in the heart area only it will be more higher when compared with other fluid areas. So that's the point here. It's the small portion of current also spreads all the way to the surface of body. Yeah, of course, only small current, because heart is on left side, only near that heart area only there will be large current. But in the remaining body parts only small currents will spread. Even with that small currents we can get this waves. So small current spreads all the way to the surface of body. If the electrodes are placed on the skin on opposite sides of the heart, the electrical potentials are generated by current and this can be recorded. That recording is nothing but our ECG. So let us see the characteristics of ECG. ECG have mainly P wave, QRS complex and also we have T wave. So you know PQRS, T in alphabetical order, PQRS, yeah. So we call QRS as complex, not wave, because it is a mixture of Q wave, R wave and S wave. Actually, these are not three independent waves normally. In most of the cases, it remains as a complex. Only sometimes it may divide into waves. So you can see here, often they are like complex only, but not always. Sometimes they may divide into three separate waves like Q wave, R wave and S wave. So let us see what is P wave. So P wave is nothing but atrial depolarization. So now it's time to see the diagram to understand. So you can see the normal electrocardiogram. So this is a P wave and this is a QRS complex and this is a T wave. So this continues on our sheet. So this P wave, you can see, so this P wave is mainly due to atrial depolarization. So this is also like action potential. We already discussed the action potential of heart. First we have the wave of depolarization, next repolarization. So in heart, you know, first we have atria, next we have ventricles below. So first the atrial depolarization, next followed by ventricular depolarization, and next followed by atrial repolarization, and of course ventricular repolarization. So first the P wave, you can see this P wave represents the atrial depolarization, its action potential, which is formed before the atrial contraction begins. So you know, atria should contract before its contraction only this P wave is formed. This is because of atrial depolarization. And next comes the QRS complex. This QRS complex is mainly due to ventricular depolarization. So atrial depolarization and next ventricular depolarization. This also takes place before the contraction of ventricle. That is, the depolarization wave spreads through the ventricles. And next comes the T wave. So before that, you can understand here now, both P wave and QRS wave, both these waves are like depolarization waves, because this is in atria depolarization and this is ventricle depolarization. So P waves and QRS waves, both are depolarization waves. So that is a key point to remember. And next let us see atrial repolarization. You know, as atria undergoes depolarization process, it should also come back to its normal RMP, you know. So it should also undergo the process of repolarization. So that is atrial repolarization. It stays from like about 0.15 to 0.20 second after the termination of P wave. So that is important. Atrial repolarization takes place after the termination. So you can see this is a P wave beginning and this is a P wave ending. So after the ending of the P wave only our atrial repolarization also start here. So you can understand that even our atrial repolarization is in the QRS complex, but it is not shown because it is of like very small time and also very small amplitude. So only our ventricular depolarization is seen as QRS complex, but normally even atrial repolarization also lies within the QRS complex. So this atrial repolarization, it is also known as atrial T wave. Actually seldom means it is not observed most commonly in our ECG. So that's what we are saying, atrial repolarization is not seen in ECG. Only our atrial depolarization as P wave and ventricular depolarization as QRS can be seen. Even ventricular repolarization can be seen as T wave, we will see that. So this atrial repolarization time is like about 0.15 to 0.20 second after the termination of P wave. This also lie in the QRS complex. And next T wave. T wave is due to ventricular repolarization. It occurs only after 0.25 to 0.35 second after depolarization. So after, of course, after depolarization only repolarization takes place. This is about ventricle, that is a T wave. So you can see this T wave is mainly due to ventricular repolarization. So let us see from beginning. P wave is due to atrial depolarization, QRS is due to ventricular depolarization, and T wave is due to ventricular repolarization. So it's a very simple complex, simple part. So normally the ventricle repolarizes after 0.20 second after depolarization of QRS wave, but in others also sometimes it may vary up to like 0.35 seconds. So the repolarization extend up to 0.1 seconds. So T wave is also called as prolonged wave. So among all these waves, you have a question, which is the prolonged wave? T wave, because the repolarization process prolongs. So even the T wave also prolongs along with it. So that's what in a ECG. So but the voltage is less than QRS. Yeah, it prolongs. If it prolongs, we may think even the voltage is high, but that is the wrong. The voltage is not high in the case of T wave. The voltage of QRS complex is only higher when compared with the T wave. And next, coming to monophasic action potential of ventricular muscle. So what is this monophasic? Monophasic is nothing but like normal action potential which is going on in a ventricular muscle. We'll see the diagram and understand it. So here, this you can see, this is a monophasic part of our ventricle. So this is our monophasic action potential of ventricular muscle, which actually lasts between 0.25 to 0.35 seconds. And this monophasic, you can see, it's like similar to our ECG pattern. So this QRS complex is nothing but depolarization and T wave at the end of repolarization, or you can say ventricular repolarization at T wave, QRS ventricular depolarization. So you can see the monophasic pattern is also following our ECG pattern at exact intervals of time. So here you can see, now normally ventricle repolarize after 0.20 after depolarization. Yeah, this is already completed. So QRS complex start at the beginning of monophasic action potential. Yeah, you can see at the beginning of action potential. And T wave appears at the end, that is in a repolarization. So therefore, the current also flows to the surface of the body to produce a ECG. Yeah, that's what we are discussing, by means of mainly fluid cavities, fluid in our body, body fluids. So horizontal calibration lines. Yeah. So now we need to observe the ECG paper and understand this. So you can see here we are having small horizontal lines and also we are having vertical lines. So what they mean in our ECG today, let us understand. So the horizontal calibration lines are 10. And these are of small line divisions upward or downward in ECG, which mainly represent the 1 millivolt with positivity in upward direction and negativity in downward direction. So we can see the 10 small lines, these are the vertical 10 small lines. In upward direction, they show positivity, and in downward direction, they show the negativity. That is the saying, and it is having 1 millivolt. And next, coming to vertical calibration lines, are the time lines which represent the time. So here the vertical lines which represent the time and the horizontal lines which represent the 1 millivolt. So paper run in the speed of, so ECG paper, you know, it should run under the machine. So it runs under the speed of 25 millimeter per second, and each 25 millimeter in horizontal direction is equal to 1 second, and each 5 millimeter segment is indicated by dark vertical lines. So you can see here the dark vertical lines and represents the 0.20. so the dark vertical lines, nothing but they are representing the time of 0.20 second, and they are broken into 5 smaller intervals by thin lines, each represent the 0.04 seconds. So these are further divided into by horizontal lines into, you can see this 5 and this 5 5. So this is about like 0.04 seconds. So if you remember this time, it will be easy to calculate some calculations related to ECG. And next, when the electrodes are placed away from the heart, the QRS complex voltage is only 3 to 4 millivolts. This is very small with comparison of monophasic action potential of like about 110 millivolts. Because this monophasic action potential is nothing but we are directly taking it from our ventricles or directly from the heart. But this electrodes are placed away from the body, means away from the heart. As they are away from the heart, the millivolt is decreasing. So recorded directly at the heart muscle membrane. Yeah, so we get 110 millivolts if we directly like measure it by means of monophasic action potential, but because with the ECG we get like about 3 to 4 millivolts. So when ECG is recorded from electrodes of two arms or one arm or one leg, the voltage of QRS is like about 1 to 1.5 millivolts from the top of R wave to bottom of S wave, means from the top of R wave to the bottom of S wave. The voltage of P wave is between 0.1 and 0.3, and the voltage of T wave is between 0.2 to 0.3. So these are some millivolts values to remember. And next, coming to PQ and PR intervals. Yeah, so we have intervals, segments, those all things we need to remember. So here you can see this is an interval, PR. Here you can see this is PR interval at the beginning of P wave and at the end of P wave. So remember that in PR interval as the name, but R wave is not involved here, only at the beginning of P wave and ending of P wave, or you can say at the beginning of Q wave. So that is the PR interval. So once, let us check out. So the PR interval is also called as PQ interval. It is because, you know, from beginning of P to beginning of Q. So the time between the beginning of P wave and the beginning of QRS complex is the interval between the beginning, it is nothing but a PR interval. So it is the interval between the beginning of electrical excitation of atria, that is, you know, atrial depolarization, and the beginning of excitation of ventricles, that is ventricular depolarization. So the normal PQ interval is like about 0.16 second, and it is often called as PR interval because the Q wave is absent. Yeah, we know normally independently Q wave is absent, so this is also called as PR interval. And next, coming to QT interval. So QT interval, so you can see the QT interval, it is covering almost like it is beginning from QRS interval and ending at the end of T wave. So this is called as QT interval. So QT interval is a contraction of ventricle which lasts almost from beginning of Q wave or R wave if the Q wave is absent to the end of T wave. Yeah, that is nothing but R QT interval. It lies like about 0.35 seconds. And next, let us check out the rate of heartbeat. So actually, we can find out the rate of heartbeat by means of ECG, mainly by checking the RR interval, that is between 2 hours. You can see here, between 2 hours we can get one cardiac cycle, or we can complete one heart rate. So like this, we can find out the heart rate by means of RR interval. And heart rate is nothing but the reciprocal of time interval between two successive heartbeats. That is, time is like about 1 second. So you know, normal heart rate 72 beats per minute, but here it's given as 60 beats per minute, because you know, in one RR interval is equal to 1 second. So for 60 seconds, for 1 minute, if you take, we'll get 60 beats, right? So like that, they calculated this. And the normal interval between two successive QR complexes in adult person is 0.83 seconds. That is between two QRS complexes. This is one QRS, next QRS. It is between 0. So you can see here the time values. So even with this time values, we can check out how much time is between what interval. Yeah. 0.83 seconds, which is heart rate of 60 by 0.83 times, that is 72 beats per minute in an adult. And the flow of current around the heart during the cardiac cycle is nothing but done by recording the electrical potentials from a partially depolarized mass of syncytial cardiac muscle. So this is what we are talking about. So you can see, in a syncytial cardiac muscle, this we know normally, inside the cell, in a resting cell, we know always there is negative potential inside because of a resting membrane potential, and positive outside because you know, more positive ions are outside. But whenever the cell gets depolarized, you know, the reverse takes place, that is, inside becomes positive and outside becomes negative. So this is what they are meaning to say here. So let us check out this. So we are here, yeah, recording electrical potentials from a partially depolarized mass of syncytial cardiac muscle. So normally the exterior of heart is positive and interior is negative in resting stage. As the cardiac syncytium becomes depolarized, the negative charges leak to outside of depolarized muscle fibers, making the surface electronegative, and remain surface which is still polarized is with plus sign. Yeah, you know, always not complete may get depolarized. Some part may still remain positive if it is still in polarized state. And the meter, therefore the meter connected with the negative terminal on the area of depolarization and positive terminal on the area on the still polarized areas record positive. So here you can see the meter is connected with negative terminal on the area of depolarization. Negative terminal on the area of depolarization. So now let us see the flow of currents in chests around the heart. So when one portion of ventricle depolarizes and becomes electronegative, the electrical current flows from depolarized area to polarized area in large continuous routes. So we know this already, you know, it sweeps along, so it is called syncytium. We already discussed in our action potential video. So during the Purkinje fibers, you know, fast conduction inside of ventricle becomes electronegative and outer walls become electropositive, with electric current flowing through fluids surrounding the ventricles. Yeah, so along with elliptical paths as demonstrated by curving arrows. So you can see the curving arrows. These are demonstrating how the current from ventricle is passing. So if algebraically the averages all lines of current flow, we get elliptical lines. So the average current flow occurs with negativity toward the base of heart and positivity towards the effect. So in the base of the heart we have negativity, and in our apex of the heart we have positivity. So this is an important keyword to remember. And next, coming to depolarization. Normally depolarization spread from endocardial, this we already discussed in our last video, from endocardial surface outward by ventricular muscle mass. And average direction of current flow reverse for about like 0.01 second, flowing from apex to base and ventricle, because the last part of heart to be depolarized is the outer wall of ventricle near the base of the heart. Yeah, the base of the heart is depolarized last. And so in normal ventricles, the current flows from the negative to positive, that is from nothing but the base to the apex, in entire cycle of depolarization except at the end. So the electrode near the base is negative and the electrode near the apex is positive, and recording meter will show positive recording in ECG. So the base is negative and apex is positive, recording meter will show positive, because you know the vector is towards positive, biggest dipole vector. So now we'll come to our important part, that is our electrocardiographic leads. So first, by means of diagram, we'll understand the bipolar leads. Entovin triangle is present in our bipolar leads. Very easy process. So actually, as I said, it is connected. One electrode is connected to the right arm, another one to the left arm, and one to the left leg. So you can see in the right arm, we have, always remember, the right arm is always negative, and the left arm is positive to one side and negative to one side. Why, we will understand. And the left leg is positive. So if you remember, right leg is not included in our Entovin triangle. So here, how I we use this positive charges, we'll see here. The only remember that the right arm is always negative. So negative with positive will give one vector, one lead here. And again, it should be like positive and negative, not positive positive, not negative negative. There should be always opposite charges. So you can see negative with, that is left arm with left leg, negative positive again here. Negative positive, right arm with left leg. So like this. So that is what they are arranged. So let us see the theory now and understand this. So now we need to understand three bipolar leads. So the bipolar means two electrodes on the limbs. Yeah, mainly why this name has come, bipolar. Bipolar means mainly we are using two arms, right? On right arm and left arm we are using leads. So it is called as bipolar leads. And it is mainly, you know, we use this graph by a computer based system with electronic display, of course. So here we have mainly the three leads. What are those? The first lead is a negative terminal which is connected to the right arm. So the negative terminal, yeah, connected to the right arm, and the positive terminal is connected to the left arm. Yes, and that is above zero voltage line in a ECG. So this is mainly the lead one. So this is the lead one, that is from negative right arm to positive left arm. This is the lead one. And now let us see what is lead 2. Lead 2 is to mainly record the limb lead 2. It is a negative terminal connected to right arm, that is here. Negative terminal connected to the right arm and positive terminal to the left leg. So this is the lead 2 in our Entovin triangle or bipolar lead. So in the lead 3, that is a negative terminal connected to the left arm, yeah, and the positive terminal which is connected to our left leg. So this is our third lead. So this is how we get the leads. Always remember, it should be opposite signs, negative positive. So first lead, second lead, and third lead. In middle we have our heart. So that's what is in our topic. So this means ECG will record positively when the left arm is negative with respect to left leg. What they are saying, ECG will record positively when left arm is negative with respect to left leg. ECG will record positive. There is lead 2. So lead 2, you can see ECG is recording positive. Lead 2 ECG is recording positive because more